الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإذ بوأنا لإبراهيم مكان البيت ألا تشرك بي شيئا وطهر بيتي للطائفين والقائمين والقائمين والركع السجود عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول من حج لله فلم يرفث ولم يفسق رجع كيوم ولدته أمه رواه البخاري صدق الله العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين All thanks, sujood, shukur, only for Allah Jalla Jalalu, amma nawalu. La jiddalahu wa la niddala wa la shibhala. Laysa ka mislihi shay. And Allah Jalla Jalalu, Rabbi Jalla wa ala, subhanahu wa ta'ala, say, ala lahul khalqu wal amr. So, according to this ayah, and according to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, every believer, mu'min and Muslim, has to express shukur and sujood always. Even he is ill or poor, everybody has to pronounce shukur on all conditions. And peace, blessing, salutation, salat and salam be upon our beloved Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, this is the moon of Dhul Hajjah. I have chosen today to talk about Hajj, Millat Abikum Ibrahim, about Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam and Ismail. And usually it comes the discussion of our Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam once gave a sermon and said, Ya ayyuhan nas, O mankind, qad furida alaykum al-hajju fa hujju. Allah jalla jalalu azza wa jalla made for you mandatory and obligatory fard hajj fa hujju. So perform it as an obligatory. Interesting thing, Abuna Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam, he also used to this sentence, Subhanallah. Al-jinsu yamiru ila al-jins. That is makula. That is very mashhur makula of Arab people. Al-jinsu yamiru ila al-jins. Prophet Sayyiduna Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam used this sentence. Then after later time, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also used this sentence, Subhanallah. And the Prophet also said, Ana du'a'u abina Ibrahim. The Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I am dua of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Because when Sayyidina Ibrahim and Ismail built the Kaaba, they made supplication. Rabbana ba'ath fihim rasula. Oh Allah, make from my offspring a prophet. Who is he? He is Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Brothers and sisters, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about this sacrifice. Oh my prophet said, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, fi surat An'am, verse number 162 and 163. Oh my prophet said, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَا وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Same thing Prophet Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam used to say. What is that? أَسْلَمْتُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Explanation is same, but meaning is different. Subhanallah. Salati, my prayer. Wa nusuki, my sacrifice. Wa mahyaya, my life. Wa mamati, my death. Lillahi, only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He's the Lord of all, Lord of mankind, zinkind, and all that exists. It is called Rabbul Alameen. La sharika lahu. He has no partner. Who says? Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is the statement of Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam. Inni wajjahtu wajhiya lilladhi fatara as-samawati wal arda hanifa wa ma ana minal mushrikeen. Statement of Ibrahim alayhi salam. Statement of Muhammad alayhi salam. What is that? Wa ana awwalul muslimin. I mean the first of Muslim. Who says? Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam. What means Muslim? Muslim who submits for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is not only naming Muslim. Muslim. Those who are submitting always for the sake of Allah, they are all Muslimin. And Allah Jalla Ala said about Muslimin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said fi surah al-Baqarah, verse number 112. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Bala man aslama wajhahu lillahi wa huwa muhsin. بَلَا مَنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجَهَهُ لِلَّهِ وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala responded about Muslimin. Yes, مَنْ أَسْلَمَ وَجَهَهُ. So whoever submits for the sake of Allah, his face, وَهُوَ مُحْسِنٌ. He is a Muhsin. He is a Muhsin. Those are submitting. He is a Muhsin. Remember it. One is Muslim and another is Muhsin. The Muhsin, that is the first grade than Muslim. Muhsin, it has the greatest grade than the Muslim. And Allah Jalla Ala, Rabbi Jalla Wa Ala, Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala, say regarding Muhsin, about their reward. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, those are Muhsin, for them. فَلَهُ أَجْرُهُ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِ. his reward with his Lord. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the best about their reward. Subhanallah. Those became muhsin to submit Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah named them muhsin. Those are muhsin like Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam, like Nabiyeen wa Siddiqeen wa Shuhadai wa Salihin. These are all muhsineen. Inna Allah yuhibbul muhsineen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves muhsineen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, the reward of muhsin with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah knows the best. What is the reward? Subhanallah. Subhanallah. No doubt, Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam, he was muhsin. When they threw on the blazing fire, what became, you know the story? The fire became coolness and safety. He is a muhsin. If we do like him, inshallah we are muhsin. Oh, zaman ame muazzaste. حامل قرآن کر او زمانہ میں معزز تھے حامل قرآن کر اور تم خار بنے ہوئے تارک قرآن کر عجیبی ہو جو ابراہیم کا ایمان پیدا آگ کر سکتی تھی اندازِ گلستہ پیدا if you become like Ibrahim, of course, doubtless, your fire will be coolness like Ibrahim. There are muhsin, those are doing like Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam and Ismail alayhi salatu salam and like our Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, O ana awwalul muslimin, wa bidhalika umirtu. And of course, indeed, I have been commanded. What is that? To say, ana awwalul muslimin. I am the first of Muslims. Subhanallah. So you have to think about our iman and about our heart. Are we Muslim really? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ On Saas shall be no fear, nor shall they grieve. On Saas, like them, like the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam. Brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam, وَإِذْ بَوَّأْنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ When I showed the site of house. What is that? That is Kaaba, Al-Baytul Atiq. Kaaba has a several name. Makkah, Ummul Qura, Ummul Haram, Baladul Amin, Al-Ma'amun. These are all the name of Makkah. Allah Jalla Ala said about Ibrahim, وَإِذْ بَوَّأْنَا لِإِبْرَاهِيمَ مَكَانَ الْبَيْتِ Remember when we showed Ibrahim the site of the house. I showed the site. It was blind. Nobody knew about our Kaaba. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pointed it. Why? Allah want to build with their hand. With Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salatu salam. Why? That is the thing. That is the essence of Islam. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Allah want to free this house from the associating others, from the idols, from the asnam. All the people of this world, they were associating others except prophets. Except the Ummah of Prophet. Then Shaitan made them devil, like Shaitan. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala showed the site of house, Ibrahim alayhi salam. Oh Ibrahim, I showed you this house. Why? Allah tushrik bi shay'a. Don't associate others with me. Number one thing. That is the number one point to make masjid, to make Kaaba, to build Kaaba, and to make the masjid, to remove the shirik, remove the asnam from the masjid, to remove the bid'ah from the masjid. That is the number one thing of ibadah and worshiping. Remove the bid'ah, remove the shirik, associating others from the masjid. Allah tushrik bi shay'a. Do not associate others with me. Who says? Allah Jalla Allah. Number two. وَالطَّهِرْ بَيْتِيَ لِلطَّائِفِينَ وَالْقَائِمِينَ وَالرُّكَّعِ السُّجُودِ. And purify, clean my house, clean my house, sanctify my house. Why? There are worshippers, my abid, ta'ifin, those are compassing around this house, those are making circling the house, wa ta'ifin wal qa'imin, and those are praying, wa ruk'a'in, and those are bowing down, wa sujud, and those are making prostration. Make this house clean, O my Prophet, subhanallah. So this is not a shameful thing to clean the masjid, subhanallah. This is the deed of Prophet, to sanctify the masjid, to purify the masjid, subhanallah, to clean the masjid. Not only dirty thing, a lot of thing is dirty, shirik, bid'ah. These are also dirty thing. And Allah Jalla Ala said about Ibrahim, oh Ibrahim, you built my house, now you have to proclaim for the mankind, for the Hajj, subhanallah. No people, no single person were over there. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Ibrahim to proclaim the man, to proclaim the mankind to come here and to circle around this house? Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the best about his house. Al-Bayt al-Atiq, al-Ma'mun, man dakalahu kana amina. If someone enters in this house, he is in the state of secure. Subhanallah. If a mosquito, if a biting animal, hasharat, he is safe from the killing, subhanallah. In the Jahiliyyah, someone murdered and he entered the Bayt al-Haram, al-Kaaba. He was free, subhanallah, subhanallah. Man dakalahu kana amina. So if someone enter in this house, subhanallah, he is free. Subhanallah bihamdihi wa subhanallah azim. He is free from the committing sin. He is under the zimma of Allah Jalla Ala, subhanallah. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, oh my Ibrahim Khalil, wa'addin fil nasi bil hajj. You and your son build this house. So now proclaim to mankind for hajj. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is talking with Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam. The Quran gives evidence, proofs. This is the talking, the conversation between Allah and Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam said, oh Allah, why should I proclaim it? No, there is no single person here. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Ibrahim, this is the explanation and tafsir of this ayah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Ibrahim, oh Ibrahim, proclaim mankind. Those will get ability to make cause. They will listen your da'wah, subhanAllah. They will listen your recalling. Where? On the Alam Aruha, subhanAllah. Brothers and sisters, then Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam proclaimed the human being on the Mount of Qubais. Qubais, the mount, this is the Ummul Jibal, mother of all mountain. It is the Qubais mount. And Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam climbed on the Mount of Qubais, and he put his hand on his ear, and he said, Ya ayyuhan nas, hujju, subhanAllah. Like Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya ayyuhan nas, kat furida alaykum al-hajj, fa hujju. Then all the hujjas listened his calling, subhanAllah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَدِّنْ فِي النَّاسِ بِالْحَجِّ يَأْتُوكَ رِجَالًا وَعَلَى كُلِّ ضَامِرٍ يَأْتِينَ مِنْ كُلِّ فَجٍّ عَمِيقٍ. Proclaim to the mankind for the Hajj, they will come to you on foot and on every lean camel. Where? From the deep area of this world. SubhanAllah. Oh Ibrahim, you didn't know who will come in this house. They will come on foot and by their right on camel. And Allah Jalla Ala said about Ibrahim, Oh Ibrahim, they will come to you. SubhanAllah. This is the respect of Ibrahim. Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam is no more to us. But why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, they will come to you? Why? This is the respect for Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam. Prophet Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Wal hajjul mabrooru laysa lahu jaza'un illa al-jannah. The reward of Hajj is nothing but Jannah. SubhanAllah. So those have ability to make and to perform the Hajj, they should do very soon. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, be like my prophet. وَتَرَكْنَا عَلَيْهِ فِي الْآخِرِينَ. The shi'ar, symbol of Ibrahim and Ismail. That is the taqwa. And also Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used that. It wouldn't be sunnah if our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he didn't do. But Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ibrahim, he is our father of nations. So all a lot of activities of Hajj, this is the commemorating of Ibrahim and Ismail alayhi salatu salam. Brothers, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, and you know the story. What is that? Ibrahim alayhi salam was tested by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he was ready for major test. SubhanAllah. And Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi salam also followed him to them, to Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam. Brothers, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Inna hadha lahu al-bala'ul mubin. This is the manifest test. And why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Wa tarakna alayhi fil akhirin. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, we left this tradition among generation in the later times. Brothers and sisters, so we have to make this performance as our ability. This country is, this is very tough to make sacrifice, to make qurbani. So far place, this, that is slaughtering house. So if we have ability to do these activities and this rite, all these ritual activities are will be granted according our prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants from us piety and taqwa, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to see our taqwa and our sacrifice, our submitting. Sayyiduna Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam would slaughter his son. Why? Because of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wouldn't like do like this activities, this doing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala released Ibrahim to give him as a gift ram, cattle. Brothers and sisters, so that is the tradition from Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam, not only slaughtering cattle, a lot of things like Safa wal Marwa, inna Safa wal Marwa bin Sha'airillah, sacrifice, Ramiul Jamar, and to visit Mina. These are all commemorating of Ibrahim and Ismail and Hajar. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would like their activities. Mam Hajara, subhanallah, Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam kept them in the deserted area. A little boy, all water and belongings finished, and Ibrahim Ismail alayhi salam used to cry for the water. You know the story. And mother Ajra would run from the top of the mount to the another mount. Subhanallah. Allah liked this activity. Subhanallah. Allah liked this attitude. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala liked this situation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it symbol for the Muslims. Subhanallah. Inna Safa wal Marwata min Sha'airillah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about this commemorating, these are all symbols. And every Muslim and mu'min has to catch lesson from there. And number one thing, to be submissive. Brothers and sisters, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us tawfiq, gave us hayat. A lot of brothers and sisters are no more in this moon, but they were before. Our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he would command us to do like this ritual activities. Brothers, so in this moon, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about the respect of this moon, about the respect of Uquf Arafah. And this is very authentic hadith. The companion of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, his name is Abu Qatada. His name is Abu Qatada. Sayyiduna Abu Qatada radiyallahu anhu narrated this hadith, and he said the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about the observance on the day of Arafah, about the Saum on the day of Arafah. Then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said regarding that, يُكَفِّرُ السَّنَةَ الْمَاضِيَةَ وَالْبَاقِيَةَ. Subhanallah. To make fasting on the day of Arafah, this is an expiation for his sin for the previous and current year. Subhanallah. To make fasting before the Eid day. And that is mashhur hadith. If someone is, he has good health, he has to do it. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and Ummul Mu'mineen Aisha Siddiqa radiyallahu anha said, "Ma min yawmin akthara min ay yu'tika Allahu fihi 'abdan min an-nar min yawmi Arafah." Rawahu Muslim. And shortly, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Rabbi jalla wa ala frees the dweller of hellfire on this day a lot. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't do before like this day. Subhanallah. And we have to make supplication, to make fasting on the day of Arafah, and to make donation a lot. brothers and sisters. So that is the very important thing for the Eid al-Adha, to make us submissive for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to follow regarding Sharia, subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us ability. Subhana rabbika rabbil izzati amma yasifun. Wassalamun ala al-mursaleen.